Well, this is my last rant about audio. Anyway, guys, the best recordings, the best rock recordings, and the best all-around stuff ever done on tape was done on the 16-track, 2-inch format. All the old Led Zeppelin stuff that we love with the great bass. 24-track, 2-inch analog. I some of those recordings just are beyond belief. There's some books that I could recommend if you really wanted to understand the physics and some of the stuff that's really involved in making a really good recording. But anyway, this is sort of my last rant about it. Analog versus digital. I hope you like it. Cheers. Well, I wanted to do another video about digital and analog audio and recording, and the reason why digital doesn't always get it. And when you see this, hopefully, you'll get it. Sort of. I get it. And I understand why the qualities of analog are more pleasing to my ear. And it's because of the transitions between different little bits of music. And that's all an analog recording is just a bunch of tiny little slices of music, but they seem to join together much more smoothly in an analog fashion. And when you see this, you're gonna laugh, but this is how it's done. Wait. Okay, so if we look at this piece of white paper, think of the white paper as no sound. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sound. It could be a bass drum, it could be a bass guitar, it could be me screaming at my wife. No, that's not true. Oh, frick, focus camera. So anyway, here's, oh fuck, screwed that up. Hold on. Okay, this is a sound. And that's sort of what it looks like. Okay, now I'm going to take it over to the sampler. Now, what the sampler is going to do to my sound is it's going to slice it into a bunch of little pieces and give it numbers. I think. What the hell? Oh, there it is. Sampling! Okay, so now the computer has a whole bunch of little bits that are stored as numbers. And now, this is why we have a fail. Stand by. When the computer puts this all back together, and it will, it does, it looks like it's all in there. The problem is the transitions where all these little slices took place. Sometimes the computer has to guess which way to go. Do I go left? Do I go right? You remember rounding off numbers in school? It's like, okay, it's three. It goes to, above. You get what I'm saying? So sometimes, even though it sampled things perfectly, it rounded things off when it was time to play it back. And that sort of depends on the playback device as well as the machine that actually grabbed it in the first place. So that's why, when I did that little demo, I'm going to do it again, I don't care. But I'm going to sample the record really like the highest quality I can. And I'll play back the record, and you'll see that the computer and the digital to analog converters, they make decisions that weren't necessarily real in the first place. So that's why it sounds more brittle and choppy, because that's sort of what it does to the sound. Cheers, folks.